In Sparta, by contrast, women were everywhere. Imagine airlifting all the men between the ages of 7 and 60 out of the street, and you get a feeling of what it must have been like. For a start, there were more girls than boys, because they weren't victims of a state program of infanticide. And if men weren't away fighting or training, they were relaxing with their male colleagues in the common messes. Women would have dominated the day-to-day life of the city. The simple visibility of Spartan women made them objects of fear and fascination to non-Spartan men. Homer called Sparta Kalligeneia, the land of beautiful women. The beauty of Helen of Troy, originally Helen of Sparta, was legendary.
Of course, not every Spartan woman who looked at herself in a mirror like this could have lived up to her standards. But they were uniquely fit. Spartan girls had an upbringing unparalleled anywhere else in Greece.
As part of their state education, the thigh flashers would come down here to the banks of the Eurotas in what one poet described as the Nicta di Ambrosias, the ambrosial night. The poet goes on to evoke scenes of ritual ecstatic dances and choral contests, the girls singing to each other of limb-loosening desire, tossing their long hair, being ridden like horses, and exhausted by love. It's no surprise that Sparta was one of the few ancient cities that had the reputation for encouraging girl-on-girl sex. Women and men in Sparta were used to living separate lives. At the age of 7, boys would be sent away to the agoge, the tough, uncompromising Spartan system, where they'd be schooled in the art of war. Male bonding wasn't just encouraged, it was compulsory. At the age of 12, a boy was paired with an older man, usually one of the unmarried warriors, aged between 20 and 30. This man would have looked after the boy's material needs and was responsible for his care and conduct. He was a surrogate mother and father, as well as a teacher and mentor. But he was also a lover, for institutionalized pederasty was a part and parcel of life for the Spartan warriors. These intimate relationships seem to have had lasting psychological and emotional effects on the men. When the time came for them to get married, it must have been a difficult adjustment to make. But the pragmatic Spartans came up with an unusual way to help them through their wedding night. The Spartans practiced a custom called marriage by capture. On her wedding night, a bride would have her head shaved, like a small boy in the agoge. She'd be dressed in a man's cloak and sandals and left alone in a dark room. Meanwhile, her husband would quietly leave the common mess, come to her, lay her down on a straw pallet, have sex with her, and then slip back to sleep with his comrades as usual. This wasn't just a quaint wedding night ritual. It could carry on for months or even years.